All right, so we're back, and in the previous video, we got an overview of what animation montages are, how they work, and what they can do for us. We also kind of stepped through how we're going to set up our punching sequence. So in this video, we're going to build our animation montage and set up that punching sequence, as well as do a little bit of animation retargeting to clean up some of our animations as well. So let's continue. So inside of our project here, I'm going to hop down to the content browser, and under the animations folder, we're going to right-click in an empty space, and we're going to go up to Animation, and then choose Animation Montage. Now, it's going to give us the Pick Skeleton dialog box here. If you had any other skeletons, they would be populated here. We only have the one, so go ahead and select it. And it's going to give us a new asset in the content browser and ask us to name it. So let's name it the Punching Montage, like so. And then go ahead and double-click on it to open it up. Now, it's going to open Persona for us. Notice that we are now on the Animation tab of Persona and that our Graph tab is no longer present as we are not working inside of an animation blueprint. Our Mesh and our Skeleton tabs are still here, but our Graph tab is currently gone. So traditionally, or not necessarily traditionally, I guess it depends on what you're doing at the time, but most of the time, if you open Persona with an animation blueprint, you'll get the best of both worlds because you'll have all four tabs available and presented to you. So before we start working on our montage, I wanted to take a look at our animations really quickly because there's something I wanted to point out. So let's go down to the asset browser here. And let's choose our montage example start. This is our punch start. Let's play that. It's kind of playing pretty fast inside the viewport here. That's because it's a small animation or short animation, and it's just looping it over and over again. I guess it's probably better to illustrate this with a punch. So let's choose one of our punches, actually. So if you look inside the viewport, as I scrub through our punch here, notice what happens to our character as we do so. So you can see there's a little bit of stretching happening. His left hip is all kinds of wrong. So we're going to fix that with animation retargeting. So the way we can do this is inside of our skeleton tree over here, which can be accessed from the animation tab or the skeleton tab right here. What we're going to do is click the show advanced options box here. Let's go ahead and click that. And it's going to give us the translation retargeting column. Now notice all of these settings are currently set to follow the animation. And when I say that, I mean that all of our bones over here are currently following whatever the animation is doing. So we want to change this. We want to make some adjustments to this. So what we're going to do, there's kind of a quick way that we can cheat and kind of do this, especially in our situation because we are only, we're doing a one-way animation retargeting sequence here. We are only worried about taking the animations from our character that had different proportions, using the same skeleton but different proportions, and doing the retargeting on this character. If we had to do animations from this character and passing them to the other character, there would be a little bit more work involved in that. So for our purposes, this is going to be pretty simple. So let's left click on our root bone here. That's going to select all of our bones in our character. And then right click on our root bone. And then down under bone translation retargeting, go ahead and choose the recursively set translation retargeting to skeleton. And now that's going to set all of our bones to skeleton inside of our hierarchy here. Now if we scrub through our timeline, you can see that our animation has been cleaned up. Our hip looks better. The punching looks better. However, our character is kind of floating up in the air a little bit now. So you can see that. We can fix that. We can go over to our pelvis bone, and we're going to change this one individually. So let's click the drop down here and go ahead and choose the animation scaled. So go ahead and choose that. It's going to pop our character back down. He's still floating in air a little bit, but once we get in game, you won't see that as much. I think that will be fine. And then we need to hop back to our root bone. And just to be careful, make sure that our root bone does indeed follow animation instead of the skeleton. Everything else can follow the skeleton. So that should clean up our punches. That's also going to clean up, if we go over to our idle now, our third person idle, that's also going to fix our character's arm so it's no longer dislocated as well. So with that, we are done with our retargeting for now. Let's hop back to our punching montage. So let's go back to that, double click on that. And in this center window here, this is where we're going to be setting up how our punching montage essentially work. So let me expand that up a little bit so you can kind of see that a little bit better. There are several sections in here. There's the montage section. This section up here, essentially, if I go back to our DJ example, I did the air quotes there. You didn't see it, but our DJ example, this is essentially our crate full of songs or records that we can play our animations in. So we can pull all of our animations into here. All the animations that we want to use essentially can be stored in here. And then inside of our sections, this is essentially going to be our playlist. So we can decide what gets played when and how. And then there's notifies, which we'll work on a little bit later in the series. A couple more videos from now, we'll come back to this and start working on notifies. So that we can play a particle effect whenever we have our notify in place. We'll actually set that up in here as well. There's some things that we need to do in here as well. So we'll get to that in a moment. And then there's curves. There's no tracks for animation montages, but there's curves and tracks can be found on animation sequences as well. So you have your curves, tracks, and notifies on animation sequences as well. So let's work on our animation montage. Let's queue up our crate full of tracks here. First thing we're going to do is grab our montage example start here. We're just going to left click and drag that into the middle track here on our montage. Let's go ahead and do that. And you'll see that our character starts playing that animation. Let's grab our punch one now and drag that in. So left click and drag that in like so. You see it gets put onto a separate track for clarity. Let's go ahead and grab our punch 2 now and drag that in. And then let's grab our punch, well, montage example end 1. Let's drag that in. And then our montage example end 2. So now you can see that our character plays all of those animations back to back here. There's a little bit more work we need to do inside the montage section here. Let me pause this because this is getting a little bit distracting. So I'm pausing that. We need to actually set up and define our sections for our montage here. So we can do this. This top section up here, this top part up here is where we can put our sections. So to do that, we can right click and we can go down to new montage section. So go ahead and select that. And it's going to ask for a section name. So let's go ahead and give this a descriptive name such as punch start. Because we're going to add a section for each of our animations here. So punch start. And now that we have our punch start here, a montage has to have a section by default, which is why there's this default section here. We can actually delete that. So let's select that and hit delete. Can I select delete? I'll right click on it. That's what we want to do. Let's right click on that and choose delete montage section. Because we only need the punch start, then we'll add punch 1, punch 2, punch end 1, and punch end 2. So let's go ahead and add those. Let me repause this. Let's right click and add a new montage section and call it punch 1. And right click, add a new montage section, punch 2. And right click, new montage section, punch end 1, and right click, new montage section, punch end 2. Now we need to move these sections into place. So what we're going to do, let's pause it one more time. Stop playing. Let's grab our punch. It started playing again. Let's grab our punch end 2 here, and let's move it to the start of our punch end sequence here. So it's right about there. You can mouse wheel up to get it lined up. It doesn't have to be 100% accurate, but as close as possible to the start. So there's our punch in 2. Let's grab our punch in 1 and move that over as well into position, like so, something like that. Let's grab our punch 2 sequence, the start of punch 2, put that in like so. Let's zoom out and get our punch 1 and place that like so. So now that we've defined our sections, we can actually hop down to the sections section of our punching montage. and define how our playlist are going to play out, essentially. So, first of all, you can see that our character is playing through all of those sequences back-to-back on the preview line here. We're going to hit clear to clear all those out, so hit clear. And it's going to allow us to preview each individual section as we'd like. So starting from the top, what we're going to do is click right here where it says, it's kind of cut off, but it says punch start. Go ahead and click on that punch start. And now we can choose what the next sequence is going to be played. So go ahead and click the punch one. And you can see it's been added now. So we're getting punch start and punch one. Now we can click on punch one and then add punch two. So now we're getting punch start, punch one, and punch two played. Go ahead and click on punch two and click on punch one. And watch what happens when we do this. See that it changed colors and it didn't actually add it. But what it's done is said, okay, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to loop these two back to back. So if we preview, you can see it's punch start, punch one, and our character is punch one, punch two, punch one, punch two. But we have no way to actually break out of punch one and punch two and play either our punch end one or our punch end two. So we need to make some adjustments here really quickly. We can do that inside the notify section. Our character is actually punching kind of fast here. We'll adjust that right at the end here before we wrap up this video. So let's add our way to get out of our looping sequence here. Let's go down to the notify section and let's pause. And what we want to do is as we scrub through, we want to add a notify event towards the end of our punches to check and see if our character is in fact still holding down our player is still holding down the punch button. So somewhere about right around in here, somewhere towards the end, you can see here's the start of punch two and the end of punch one. What we're going to do is right click inside the notifies bar here. So right click. And go ahead and choose add new notify. Again, there's where we can add particle effects or sounds. But we're going to add a new notify event. So go ahead and click that, new notify. It's going to ask for a name. And we're going to call this is still punching one. So is still punching one is what we're going to call that first one. And when we select it, you can look in the details panel on the upper right. What we want to do is let's go to the event section and expand that. And under montage tick type, click the drop down here and there's an option for branching point. So this is going to give us a branching point for this particular event or this particular notify. So when we get to this point, it will fire off an event where we can branch and go to a different section if we need to. So let's do the same for the end of punch two. So we're gonna scrub the time bar a little bit more towards the end, somewhere around in here, towards the end of punch two. And let's right click, add new notify, and a new notifier there. And let's call this is still punching two. And let's select it. And then in the details panel under montage tick type, let's change that to branching point. Okay, I think we are set up now with our animation montage. There's one more thing that we need to do before we close out. Well, two actually. The first is that our punching sequence looks kind of fast. Well, it's up to you. If you'd like to keep it like this, that's fine. But if you want to change that speed, you can go down to the anim asset details under rate scales, currently playing at 1.0. You can change that to say like 0.5, I'll punch slower. Or if you want to change it to, say, 1.5, I'll punch a little bit faster. I actually think I'm going to keep it at default so that this montage plays at regular rate. I thought about changing it, but I changed my mind. So we're going to keep it at 1. But if you'd like to change the playback speed of this animation, you can do it right here. So the last thing that we need to do is set up what's called a slot. Now, the slot... a quick rundown of what a slot is going to do for us, and we're going to get into this when we actually set up the slot in our animation blueprint later. What a slot is going to allow us to do is kind of split up and selectively play this montage on our character's body from, say, for example, the upper half of the body. So if we had a reload animation and we wanted to play that reload animation, but we didn't want to create a reload animation for a character that's standing, for a character that's crouched, or for a character that's jumping, etc. We could have one reload animation montage and then play that montage in a slot. I'm doing air quotes again. Play that animation slot on our character. And then what we could do is say, okay, anything, best way to describe this actually is here inside of our skeleton tree. So anything that is below the pelvis, do not apply this slot to, but anything that is above the pelvis, apply the slot to. So that will allow us to play two animations on our character based on a bone. So we're gonna get into that a little bit later and break that down a little bit better once we get to that. But we need to set that up in here first before we can do that. So to do that, we're gonna go back up to our montage section. There's a little magnifying glass here. Go ahead and click the magnifying glass to open our slots and groups. The window opened up off screen. Let me drag that in. So what we're gonna do is add a slot. It's gonna ask us for a slot name. We're gonna call it upper body because we want this to play on our upper body. But before I actually hit enter here, let me just say this too as well. This is not actually defining that we wanna play it on our upper body yet. You can name the slot whatever you would like. This is just for a reference to let me know where I want this to play. We still need to define exactly how that's going to be applied to our character's body. So I just didn't want you to associate the naming of the slot with where it's going to be played, because that's not the case. But for our reference, we're going to call it upper body. So let's go ahead and enter, and then let's save. And then we can close our window. Now we need to actually set that slot. So click the drop down here and call it the upper body slot. So let's go all the way up to the left up here inside the animation tab of Persona and save, so that we save everything. And with that, we're gonna pause here. I think that's enough for this video. In the next video, we'll hop into the animation blueprint and begin hooking up our punching montage here. So let's wrap, and we will see you in the next video.